It's about iodine particles. We've discovered in cloud that iodine is likely to be a major source of new aerosol particles in the atmosphere. We found that the iodine particles form even more rapidly than sulfuric acid particles. Now, sulfuric acid is thought to be responsible for most aerosol particle formation in the atmosphere, and in turn, these particles grow and become the seeds for cloud droplets. In fact, much more than half of all the cloud droplets in the sky start from these processes, this aerosol formation in the atmosphere. But what we've seen now is that in some parts of the atmosphere, the iodine, which is emitted from the surface and the ocean, and also melting ice, may be the dominant cause of these particles. And that's particularly in pristine regions, which are very sensitive to aerosol particle formation, like the Arctic. And that iodine is being released more abundantly as Arctic sea ice is melting and exposing more of the ocean, creating more iodine, and that in turn will create more particles, more clouds. And it's a positive feedback because clouds in the Arctic have a warming effect and they're accelerating the loss of Arctic sea ice. So in a nutshell, these particles could be responsible for a major new mechanism for accelerating the loss of Arctic sea ice. And at the moment, no climate models are basically including these particles because nobody's measured the process before. So we now have measured these processes. We're reporting them in this paper, and climate models can now do mechanistic evaluations of what the impact is on the climate. CERN provides a beautiful artificial adjustable source of cosmic rays for the experiment from a pion beam from the CERN proton synchrotron. We built the cleanest chamber in the world, so far the only chamber in the world that's capable of doing these experiments in the laboratory. What we do is we recreate the atmosphere inside a box called the CERN cloud chamber. In this case, we recreated marine conditions. We added roughly one in a million molecules of iodine. We turned on green lights, in fact, to mimic the sunlight, the photolytic processes. And so cloud's measurements are helping provide the basic experimental data that climate models need with which to understand climate change and the progression of the climate. In fact, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the world's body, scientific body that reports to governments on the status of climate and climate change, recognizes that the biggest source of uncertainty in their models is actually the understanding of these aerosols and how they've changed since pre-industrial times. So the interest, the scientific and the social interest in cloud is extremely high. What we need now is for global climate models to incorporate these new cloud results, and then we'll understand the full impact on the climate.